Welcome to Formula Offroad. In this episode, we'll be bringing you the last two rounds of the championship, which were held in Akureyri on the 8th and 9th of August. This is what the standings looked like in the unlimited class after last round. As you can see, Snorri Þór Árnason has already secured the title in this class. But everything is still wide open in the modified class, where Jón Vilberg and Bjarki are still battling it out for the title.
Jón Vilberg, þú leiðir Íslandsmeistaramóti í sérubúna kvötubíla á flokknum. Hvað verður planið í dag?
Bara vinna, auka fórskoti.
Ekkert flóknar en það?
Nei, það ekkert annað í búið.
Hvernig heldur að staðan verði í flokknum eftir fyrstu tvær breytirnar?
Ég ætla að vona ég verið efstur og Bjarki verið á eftir mér.
Gangið vel í dag?
Já, takk fyrir það.
Bjarki, þú ert 5 stigum á eftir Jóni Vilberg í sérubúna göttubílaflokknum. Þú hlýtur að stefna á Íslandsmeistaratitil í dag og morgun.
Ég verð að vinna í dag. Svo verður bara morgundagurinn að koma í ljós. Hvernig það verður?
En Bjarki, hver svona aðal munurinn á sérubúna göttubílaflokknum og sérubúnaflokknum?
Sko, við megum ekki voru ausum. Við þurfum verið með farþæðarsæti og svona bíllag á tækinu. Þetta sjá alveg hvað tegund þetta
The Unlimited Champion, Snorri Þór, lent his vehicle to his father this weekend.
Jæja, Árni, hverju megum við búast að þér hér í dag?
Já, vonandi, einhverju sjói, ég svo sem ekki vanur þessu, en nú prófa hann reyndar aðeins í ámælisháti en á helli í vorin. Við sjáum hvernig þetta fer.
En þetta þín fyrsta keppni?
Ég reyndar prófa þetta svona auka keppni fyrir 20 okkur árum á bílnum hans Halla P. Þannig gana þetta, en það langt síðan.
Þetta bíllinn sem var Íslandsmeistari, myndur þú segja að vera raunhaft að stefna sigur í dag?
Nei, ekki í dag, en við gerum okkar besta.
Gangið vel.
Takk fyrir.
Haukur Einarsson var second in last round.
Jæja, Haukur, annars ættið í síðustu keppni, stefnur á það fyrsta hér?
Það maður sjálfsögðan, svo bara kemur ljós, þetta verður hörð keppni í dag og margir hérna kom með nýja fítursa eins og Alli og Geir náttúrulega með nýja bíl og spennandi að sjá sko, þannig það allt opið.
Er það raunhæft fyrir það að stefna á fyrsta sendi hér?
Það ætti svo sem alveg vera raunhæft ef að bíllinn í lagi og allt gengur upp en þetta verður náttúrulega hörð keppni.
Gangið vel í dag.
Þakka þér fyrir.
Now on with the competition. It was the local motorsport club in Akureyri that hosted these two rounds of the championship, which were held on the Saturday and the Sunday. Here we have Grétar Óli on the first course. He drives the farmer's daughter. This is Grétar's first competition, and he makes a mistake when he comes down the slope, misses a gate, but kept going. Well, so far. Next up is Geir Evert in the sledgehammer. He is also new to the sport. He drove well in this competition and the car worked well for him. He went the right way down the slope. So let's see how he does in the climb, where Grétar Óli rolled. No, too much rebound there. Here we have Haukur Einarsson in the TAS. He simply has to do well in his fight for the title. Yes, he makes it up, but the steering fails, so he doesn't go any further. This is Magnus Sigurðsson in the cube. He competed in the first two rounds. Here he stalled the engine and couldn't get it restarted in time, so he got a red flag for it. as the maximum time allowed stationary in course is 1 minute. Here is Aron Inge in the Zombie, in the modified class. Aron is one of those who has a chance of a title in this class. But he doesn't risk too much here on the first course. Now let's see what Aron's father, Svanur, does here. He's in the unlimited class and therefore his tires have bigger scoops. No, that's the same story, not enough speed. Next up is Guðlaugur Sindri in Yellow Magic. He did well in the last two rounds and yep, he goes up here. And here he has to do a U-turn, which he does, but knocks down a stake or two and then up the last bit. Nope, so close. This is Bjarki in the Animal, putting on quite a show for the spectators. But this could cost him in the end. Here is Árni in the Choir Boy, the car that Snorri won the unlimited title in. Nope, he rolls as well and only gets 150 points. And now Jón Vilberg. He manages to get up there. And now it's just to go all the way. Nope, not quite. But he gets 230 points and takes the lead in the modified class. Next up is Alexander Maur in All In. He didn't go far because he lost the steering, so he had no control of the car. Here we have Gestur Ingólfsson in the Dream. Let's see if he'll make it. No, he speeds there. But manages to reverse. So now he has to go all the way up to make up for the lost point. Goes all the way, but rolls through the end gate, giving him 190 points. Now course 2. Guðlaugur Sindri is first to tackle it, and he makes it look all too easy. And then Bjarki in the modified class. Yep, he does it as well. This is Jón Vilberg. And since Bjarki went all the way, Jón Vilberg has to keep up with him. But when he lands from this jump, he breaks the rear diff and gives his mechanics a bit of a job to do. Here is Alexander Maur and All In. No, he's a bit too enthusiastic here and rolls it. And then Gestur. And he rolls it as well. Next up, Grettir Oli. He's very eager, and virtually jumped his way up. So this is the standings in the unlimited class after the first two courses. Guðlaugur first, Magnus second, and Grétar Óli jumped into third place. On to the third course, where Magnus and the Cube go first. Magnus goes all the way up, but goes to the wrong side of the end gate, so he only gets 220 points. Aron Ingi didn't go very far on this track. And this is the leader. Let's see what he does. No, he gets stuck here as well. And this is Arne in the quiet one. And yes, he flies over this. And then the end climb. Yes, he goes all the way and secures 350 points for going all the way, but hit one marker, giving him 20 penalty points. Next should have been Jón Vilberg, but his car was still being serviced, so he missed out on this course. So it didn't really matter for Bjarki that he couldn't make it all the way here. He still had a good lead in the modified class. Fourth and last in this class both days was Sigfús in the Fat Boy. He simply didn't have a good weekend. On to the fourth course, which had an extremely steep climb at the end. Guðlaugur still manages to get all the way up, which put him back into the lead. Jón Vilberg just made it back from service, and here, in the end climb, he breaks the rear diff again. Then Arne in the choir boy, and no, he doesn't make it all the way, and probably could have done with a bit more speed there. Alexander Már was still having steering problems, and ended the Saturday in last place. Here is Grétar Óli. The competitors could choose whether they went right up the hill, or did a left loop, which Grétar Óli chose to do, so that he could charge at it. And now, pay attention to this. This is the most spectacular roll we've seen in Formula Offroad for a very long time. Let's see what it looked like from the driver's point of view. Grétar only sustained minor bruising from this roll, but due to the roll kit's damage, Grétar had to retire for the weekend. This is Gestur Ingólfsson in the same course, turning to go up. And that's his third roll of the day. Svanur Tómasson tried to go up, ending like this, and got 220 points for his effort, but 60 minus points. then Magnus in the cube. He's in on the fight for first place, but just like what happened to Jon Wilberg, the rear diff breaks here. That put him down to fourth place. And while Magnus and his crew changed the diff, the other competitors started course 5. This is Aron Inge, which by now is in first place in the modified class. He didn't quite make it up here. And then, on to his father, Svanur Tomasson. He nailed it up the track and shows how it's done. Guðlaugur Sindri, leader of the Unlimited class, and he rolls. No, not quite. Well done that, but it doesn't quite make it up all the way. This action reminds us of a former Formula Offroad champion, Gísli Gunnar Jónsson, who was known for taking it all the way to the roll and then aborted. And now for the time course, the last course of the day. Gestur with a very nice jump, but in a fourth best time. Magnus Sigurðsson got the third best time. Árni in the choir boy got the second best time. But the unexpected best time came from Geir Evert in the sledgehammer. A very good drive from him. Svanur also did a very nice jump there. And these are the standings at the end of the first day, with Guðlaugur taking the win ahead of the newcomer Árni. Before we move on to the next day, we are going to see how the standard class got on over the weekend. It was Haukur Birgisson's fourth and last place, as usual. But he lent his car Þeytingu to his son on the Sunday race, and Snæbjörn Hauksson showed some great driving, taking third place. In third place on Saturday and fourth on Sunday was Edvald Orri driving the Bachelor. This wasn't his weekend, as he rolled his car twice. In second place on both of the days was the experienced Steingrimur Bjarnason in the Smurf. He had the chance of the title, but couldn't manage to beat his main rival, Ivar Guðmundsson. Ivar was, as usual, in a class of his own, taking the win with 500 points to Steingrimur on the Saturday and over 300 on the Sunday. Ivar Guðmundsson defended his title in this class and is a well-deserved champion. Now we move on to the unlimited and modified classes. Einar Gunnlaugsson, a former champion, was competing in this event.
Einar Gunnlaugsson, kominn aftur í torfaruna?
Kannski ekki alveg kominn aftur en að prófa þetta í dag.
Það kominn svolítið langt síðan að þú prófaði síðast, ekki satt?
Jó, ég að vísu fíblaði sjálfa mig hérna 2009. Það gekk ágætlega en það nú ekki víst að verði núna.
En þetta sami bíll og keftir á hér í kringum aldamótin, ekki satt?
Jó, jó, fyrir aldamót aðalega.
Let's hear what Einar had to say about his car when it was new in 1997.
Já, hann bara, hann á að þola hnjaski miklu betur og hérna, þyngdapunkturinn sem sagt inn í miðjum bíl núna, sko, hann nokkuð jafnþungur aftan og fram.
Og ja, hvað svona búið að breytast í torfærunni? Hver munurinn á bílnum í dag og hann var þegar þú keftir á honum hér fyrir aldamót?
Hann svona komið nýtískulegri búnaður í hann, stór mótor í honum. En við vorum svo sem konum með stóra vélar en þær virkuðu ekki alltaf alveg. En þessi virka vel.
Og það bara mótorinn sem búið að breytast?
Nei, fjöðrunin. Kominir einhverjir vökvademparar í þetta og...
En þú kannt nú alveg að kera torfarubíl, við hverju megum við búa staðir hér í dag?
Já, þú sagðir þú kannt, ég kunni kannski en það verður að koma í ljós í dag hvort ég kunni það ennþá.
Þannig að við fáum að sjá þá bara í dag?
Já, já, við það verður bara að koma í ljós en það náttúrulega númer eitt að hafa bara gaman að þessu og frábæta gesti að lána mig bílinn, skilur, það bara snillt.
Það segir bara gangið vel í dag.
Herru, takk fyrir það.
Einar Gunnlaugsson drove well to begin with, but had to surrender to some mechanical issues later in the race and finished 8th. Here's the winner of the first day, Guðlaugur Sindri Helgason.
Já, Gulli, til hamingju með sigurinn í gær.
Já, takk fyrir það. Það var flottur dagur.
Og hvað, bíllinn alveg stráheill eftir daginn í gær, eða?
Já, ég held það. Ég svo leiðis, bara eins og hann verður.
Hvernig líst þér á brautirnar hérna í dag?
Það var alveg að svipa, sko. Þetta bara spurning að drastlið hangi í lagi, sko.
Og hvernig heldur að staðan verði eftir fyrstu tvær brautir?
Ég verður auðvitað bara síðastu, sko. Ég hugsa að þetta bara falla á tónum, sko. Hinir voru lélegir en ég í gær, sko. Það ekki það að ég væri svo góður.
Guðlaugur was right. He was in last position after the opening two courses, after this role in course 1. This wasn't to be his day, and he finished 6th. On the Saturday, Aron Ingi was leading the modified class right up to the time course. But there, he made a mistake, not going through this gate. Let's hear what he had to say before the race on Sunday.
Aron, þú leitir keppnina í gær fram á síðustu braut. Hvað gerist þar?
Ég mista hliði, alveg stresskasti. Maður var að berjast við fyrsta sætið við Bjarkar Reynis. Hann æsti mig svo mikið upp að ég bara klúðraði tímaþrautinni. Það ég freka fúll.
Jón Vilberg still had a chance of the title in the modified class.
Jón Vilberg, þú lentir í talsjónum bílunum í gær, ekki satt?
Jú, það passar.
Og hvað var það sem bilaði í bílnum?
Afturdrifið var að gefa sig.
Og bíllinn kominn í fullkomið lag fyrir daginn í dag?
Ekki alveg, það búið að redda þessu svona, skítredda þessu.
Þú ert 3 stigum á eftir Bjarka í Íslandsmeistaramótinu, þannig að þú verður að vinna Bjarka hér í dag.
Já, passar. Það dugur ekkert annað.
Bjarki, þú sigraðir í gær og leiðir nú Íslandsmótið. Hvað verður stefnan í dag?
Bara að reyna að sigra aftur.
Þú ert 3 stigum á undan Jónni Vilberg, þannig að það má ekki mikið út að bregða.
Nei, ég þarf svolítið að treysta á Aron líka, raunni. Hann má alveg hjálpa mér.
Ég segi bara gangið vel í dag.
Takk fyrir bara.
This is Jón Vilberg in the first course on Sunday. But as he rolls, the rear diff breaks yet again and Jón missed a couple of courses. That put him completely out of the running for the title. But when he returned to the racing, this happened. This high-speed roll completely destroyed the car's roll cage. Jón Vilberg was taken to hospital, but only suffered minor bruising on his neck. This meant that Bjarki Reynsson easily won the race and therefore claimed the 2015 Modified Class National Championship win. Now we move on to the unlimited cars.
Árni, þú sagðir við okkur í gær að þú myndir ekki slást fyrsta sætið. Það var nú ekki raunin.
Nei, þetta munaði litlu, en annars sætið, þetta var rosa góður árangur.
Þú lítur að stefna á fyrsta í dag?
Já, sjálfsögðu. Við gefum ekkert eftir í dag.
Árni drove well on the Sunday and was 3rd before the last 2 courses with little separating the top 3.
Það er tæft, 2 brautir eftir, við sjáum hvað við getum.
Og 5. brautin framundan, hvernig líst þér á hana?
Hún verður kláruð.
Það ekkert flóknara?
Nei, ekkert flóknara.
Yes, Árni was adamant that he would finish this fifth course. But that didn't happen, to say the least. A massive roll, but the choir boy is strongly built, and after a few repairs, it was back in the action with Árni taking third place. This is Magnus Sigurðsson in the cube. Despite this roll in the first course, Magnus was leading before the fifth course. But that lead was shared with this man, Alexander Már Steinarsson in all-in. Alexander had a horrible Saturday, but was leading here before the final two courses.
Alexander, fyrsta sæti, en það gæti ekki tæpara verið.
Nei, þetta allt eins og Það bara þannig, það var, maður verið að gera vonandi betur magi í næstu þraut til að vera fyrir ofan.
Og fimmta brautin, hvernig líst þér á hana? Hún hérna fyrir aftan okkur.
Hún brött, þetta beint upp. Ég veit ekki hvað maður gerir, ætla að sjá hvað maður gerir fyrst og sér maður til hvað maður gerir.
Og svo tímabrautin?
Já, já, þá erum maður að reyna að gera góðan tíma þar.
Gangið vel.
Takk að þér.
Magnús, það getur ekki verið mikið tæpara?
Nei, þetta bara æðislegt. Þetta bara virkilega gaman að þessu, mikið spennandi.
Og fimmta brautin framundan, hvernig líst þér á hana?
Fínt, ég held að eina gullnars við einhverju vesinni þannig að geti verið að færi fyrstur í hana þannig að það verður dálítið svona kunst, það alltaf vont í þessara braut að fara fyrstur.
Og svo tímabrautin?
Já, tímabrautin, ég var nú með laskað afturskaft í síðustu tímabraut og þetta eins braut og ég kyrði bara svona þétt en ekki á fullu krafti þannig að, og ég náði mjög góðum tíma samt, þannig að ég ávona á því að ég geti gert góða hluti.
As he mentioned, Magnus is the first to tackle this penultimate course. Let's see what he and the cube can do. No, not quite, but Magnus gets 200 points for the length and 10 penalty points. Now it's Alexander's turn. If he goes all the way, he will snap the lead from Magnus. No, he doesn't give it his all and gets 180 points. So now he's 10 points behind Magnus. The result of this race then depended on this time course. The cars went through the first gate at the exact same moment, but it looks like Magnus is already pulling out lead. When Magnus goes through this gate here, we can see that Alexander is about 4 seconds behind him. And take a look at that great driving from Magnus. He drives this time course like a madman and finishes it with by far the best time and therefore took the win. Alexander had to settle with second, which is still his best result in Formula Offroad. But it was Magnus that took the second place in the championship behind Snorri Thor. This was the final episode of the Icelandic Formula Offroad. Thanks for following us here on Motors TV.